Well, hello everyone, I'm Ayani from BU4U Gaming, and today we are back in Mercury Fallen, and update 23, New Beginnings, is now out, so we'll be starting a new game, as there's a whole bunch of changes to the start of the game, so there's new starting criteria. We're not gonna have that little base where you already have a few machines running and some power. When you start the game, now you only have a few cryopods and a crate of resources, and that's it. So it's going to be a completely different experience. The colonists have been updated as well. The power system has been changed, so there's some new research to do. There's also been added plants that will grow, like wild plants that you can harvest. And yeah, there's just a bunch of changes, so we're going to try and jump into this and see if we can figure it all out. And let's go for a normal size map, and I'm not quite sure what to look at here, because it said in the patch notes that ore density is closer to your spawn. And with the previous versions of the game, you would start at that little base and you could always see it on the map, and then you could kind of look at it and say, okay, is there all these resources close to where I or where that base is? But now I don't really know how to look at these maps, because I don't know where I'm spawning on this. Do we spawn in the middle, or do we just spawn where there's the most resources, or how does that work? So I'm thinking it's probably just a good idea to get one that has, you know, a decent supply of all the different types of resources spread out throughout the map. This might be something. We have a whole bunch of stuff. I'm not quite sure what the white stuff is. There's some new colors here that I'm a little uncertain of. There's the orange and the purple. It's like our... what do they call it? Like our metals or something. And the black one is for power, so we get some fuel. And the the light blue, of course, is water, but I'm not quite sure what the white and the yellow is. Maybe it's sand, actually, and this might be stone. I think I read something about stone being a thing now. So yeah, that's what we're gonna go for. And then, of course, you can choose easy mode, where you start with an additional colonist and a robot. Or you can go for default, which is 3 colonists and 1 robot. So in easy, you would get 4 colonists and 2 robots. Or you can go for challenge mode, where you start with fewer starting colonists and limited job roles based on attributes. But we are just gonna go for default. So let's just jump into this and just see how it goes. By the turn of the 22nd century, space exploration was dominated by corporate interests. Once a task for governments, space travel became a competitive market where companies pushed boldly and blindly into the black, intent only on a return on investment. For the first time in human history, Infinity Corp was about to attempt the colonization of a planet outside of Earth's solar system. The construction vessel Mercury was launched to start the automated construction of an underground facility on an alien planet. A small research team was also sent to survey the planet before a colony ship full of settlers left Earth. The research team would awake from stasis automatically, shortly after their arrival. Or at least, that was the plan. So, let's get into this. After years of silence, decay, and settling dust, what remains of the Mercury facility bursts back to life. The screens flicker on the long, dormant stasis capsules containing the crew. They are finally ready to emerge from their long, dreamless sleep. Digital readout, satellite link offline, mission crew error, unable to establish connection to all capsules, that's not good. Facility structure critical, oh my, this is not good. So let's just hit space to pause. You can see now the time is not progressing anymore here. And oh boy, I'm gonna have to see if I can figure out how to do this, because now, of course, we don't have any machines. Previously, we would start with a biorefiner, if I remember correctly, and we would also have a little bit of power, like a coal generator or something. Where is that? Do I have to research it to get it? Maybe I do. Or maybe not. How do we get power if we... Oh boy. Okay, well, we're gonna have to see if we can figure that out. We should have some... How are we gonna research if we don't have any power? Right off the bat, I can't see any though. Research the. Oh, flicker. Okay, well, let's just try and see if we can figure all of this out. There is a little guide here, and I do see the elevator here. So that's different, because before we also had the elevator when we started out, and now you don't, so we even have to construct that one. But first of all, let's try and open these up. And this one is open already. So open capsule. Looks like my resources are in here. Okay, let's break that down. How do I okay, I guess I have to break that down before we can get our starting resources, but that's not very practical, because I assume there's a little bit of food in that one. Then, of course, we have our little robot over here, so let's get you activated. And, so, since we don't have... I know I haven't let them out yet. I'm just trying to figure out how to deal with this, because, of course, they're gonna start eating their food and stuff, so... and it's gonna probably be a little while before we have any produced food. So, let's just start out with mining a bit out here. This is gonna give us some fuel, which is good whenever we figure out how to actually burn some of it. And this is an iron oxide, and we have stone. It's harder than dirt, and I think it's made of different stuff. I don't know what we're gonna get from that. But to actually build anything, we need structure resin, right? And usually you would produce that in here. A craft station used to refine raw biomaterials, and we actually need structure resin to build one of those. So the only way I can think of to get that would be to deconstruct what is already here. So there is a tiny bit of a base here, we just don't have any machines or anything. But I think we're simply gonna get them to deconstruct everything that there is of this, even the floor. Okay, we're gonna have to click on this to deconstruct it. And then we are gonna build everything up. There we go. Because the first thing we're gonna need is definitely something. Well, we're gonna need food. What do we need for this? Yeah, we need structure resin for this. I'll probably want to get a crop field going as soon as we have 10 of these, just so we have some food coming in. And then we're gonna get a biorefiner, because once we have a biorefiner, we can produce more structure resin. Or maybe I want this first and this after, because once we have this, we can always produce more structure resin. So that might be the plan. But let's just let these people out. There we go. And we're gonna have to give them some jobs. So now that everybody's out, see, they already started doing something, so they do have some jobs. There we go. It looks like everybody is assigned, well, these two are assigned to mining. You're not doing it. Oh, you are doing a little bit, so you're assigned to deconstructing. That's clear. Let's deconstruct. That's the wrong one. I'm on mining. So let's deconstruct you and you and you. And now we have this little box here. So let's open that and see what we get. There we go. So what did we get? We got a neural stem smarts plus 4 colonist equipment. Ooh, that is a nice one. We got 20 emergency rations. We got an advanced mining laser, that's for vehicles, it's gonna be a while before we need that. And we got craft efficiency 3, double output chance, 50% for machine equipment. Okay, that is a pretty good one as well. So before we do anything else, let's just see what everybody's doing here. We have our little worker, you are set to repair, which I think is a really good idea once we get machines going. I prefer having my robots doing some repairing. It's usually a good idea in the beginning to have someone else doing it, because we are gonna need a charging pad for these guys. We don't have one right now, so my robot might run out of power, and then he won't be repairing anything, right? And the charging pad itself needs repairing. So if you only have one charging pad, especially in the beginning, it's kind of a problem if only your robots can repair, because they might be out of power and then they can't actually repair it. I kind of had that problem in my previous series. I kind of messed up with that. So then that's what you're gonna do first, and then I want you to do building next. And then I want you to do mining. So yes, that is what you're set to. And this is like your priority. So this is the first priority, second and third, and they can only have 3 jobs that they can do at a time. And let's see, you have like medium smarts, kind of medium, almost medium on muscles, and almost you're not really that fast, but yeah, it's kind of average what you can do here. Did we get one for colonists? No, we didn't. Okay. So then we have, who's the smartest? You're the smartest, so I think you are gonna be a doctor. Here we go. Yes, that is gonna be your priority right off the bat. You are kind of the strongest, you are the fastest. So when you're not playing doctor, I don't want you to be researching, because the scientist is pretty much always doing something. So once we get a scientist going, that's not what we want them to do. Right now, there's not much we can do though. The engineer is the one we need for crafting, but we don't have anything for that right now. I think maybe I just want everybody to do some mining. I might want you to be a botanist, actually, at some point. I could have you be a doctor first and foremost, and then since you are the smartest, have you be engineer next. And then I don't know what I want the third thing to be, but you can't do engineering and doctor is just every now and then. I don't know if the doctor actually does anything until you get like a medbed going, but I just want someone to be assigned to it so I don't forget about that. So I think when you're not doing any of that, you're just gonna help out doing some mining. And let's see, you are really, really strong. You're a little bit faster, so I think let's have you also be a technician, just in case, once we get machines going. And then you're gonna be a botanist. And if you're not doing either of these, what else do we have that we need right now? Biologist is kind of more a mid-game thing. It's going to be a while before we need one of these. Comm officer, that's going to be a while too. That's when we can get to the surface. And scientist, we need to get a research table going. So someone is going to have to do this fairly soon. Then we have a cook, but we don't have any cooking station, so right now they're just going to be eating raw food, so we don't really need this right now. And but it might make sense to have you be a cook, but for right now I think I just want you to do some, no, let's let you do some hauling. Maybe, well, we don't need that unless until we get storage going. You're gonna do some mining too. And then we have you over here, who are then gonna be, have engineer, have a botanist. I think eventually, as soon as we get it, you're gonna do this. And in the meantime, let's have you help out doing some deconstructing. So let's set you to be a builder, because you're not really gonna be doing any of this right now, so you're gonna go straight to this one. Yes, let's do that. So someone is going to deconstruct all these things, and some people are going to do some mining. And let's speed this up. But really, there's some things to think about here, about what to actually do, because it's very different that we don't have any machines right off the bat. There we go. So we're breaking everything down. Let's just keep doing that. We're just going to oh, there's some of the first plants. Nice. And we found a little crate over there. Awesome, let's break this down so we can get some more structures in going. I think that's a good idea. I like to slow it down just a little bit. Here we go, let's see what we get in you. Ooh, we got some mineral compound, which is what we need to make structures in. We got azurite, soft mineral form of copper. We got a colonist log. Gonna wait a bit with reading these, because as you can see, it's day 22. You kind of get them randomly, but some of them are like for day, like early days, like day 22, and some of them are like 100, like day 100 and something, or 1000 and something. So I feel like I'd rather read them when we have a bunch of them, so we can read them kind of in chronological order, right? Then we have copper ingots, iron ingots, and steel billets. So I'm not sure about these plants, because apparently Well, we can harvest them. This is a new harvest icon. I'm gonna have to get used to that. We can click on this to harvest plants, and I think I'm gonna try and harvest this because it's kind of where I want to build. But apparently they will spread, like wild plants over time, they will spread. And I think if we harvest this, it's gonna be gone. I think it's gonna disappear. So then it probably can't spread anymore, right? At least that's what I would think. And there we go. So I'm thinking maybe you want to leave some of them so they have a chance to spread, so you always have one. Like if we let this spread to two and then we harvest one of them, right? And kind of just let them spread a bit and then harvest a little bit all the time, but always leave one, for instance. But yeah, I don't know. That's something we're gonna have to figure out. So now we have kind of a big nice area here that we can start doing some building. Let's deconstruct that little floor piece there. And let's see, we have some more resources over here. I would like to mine those out. So we have some stuff we can get going on. Let's do this so they can access it. And then we have stone. I'm not quite sure what we get from that. But, and this is for fuel, always good. Generally, I just kind of want them to get a lot of resources. And yes, this is sand, just as I expected. Nice. But water. Well, we have a nice little area with water here. I just have to remember to leave some of it because we need it for cooking and other things later. So just thinking about what layout I want here. And we can do some deep mining here later, but I don't think I'm going to worry too much about it because the map is fairly big. Let's see. You can see it down here, actually. We just have this little area, so there should be plenty of other places where we can do some deep mining, but we'll see. So, to get some crafting going, first of all, let's see how many minerals we have. We have 50 mineral compound. That's not really what I needed to know, but we can turn that into structure resin. Wow, we have 154. That should get us started. Awesome. So, what do we need? We need for the biorefiner. We need refinery floor. Okay, maybe I should get these going first, actually. Crop fields. Where do I want those? I'd kind of put them over here somewhere. Can put a wall behind here. So if you put you there, maybe start down here. So let's make two for starters. Then we can put a wall in here, and then we can kind of build a kitchen over here, or maybe behind here. That could be a thing. We could build a wall, a door, right? A wall and then a door, and get through here, and then we can build our kitchen over here behind when we get to that. I think that could be an idea. So we're gonna have like an area with lots of crop fields here. Just trying to figure out exactly how I want this. Then we can have some more over here. Just have a little pathway between them. That could be an idea. Yeah, so if we say we have that, let's make one more. And then we're gonna have a wall, of course. And then we are gonna need refinery floor. I don't know. It's really hard to think of how you want everything right now because I don't know how all the power and everything works in this new update. So this is where we would have a wall, right? And we have like a corner right here. So if we just start right here and say that's our refinery floor. Now hopefully someone goes mining unless I messed up. Oh, okay. It also says build crop field and then construct elevator. We'll need to regain access to the topside facility by constructing an elevator. Scans indicate the solar panels are still functional. We can route power from the elevator. Oh, that's how we get... Ooh, okay. Well, I still want to get these things done, and it's fine that they built this refinery floor. And then we do the construct elevator and then a refinery room, apparently. But that's probably a good idea. So, do we need a special floor for this? No. Connects the underground facility to the surface. Okay, so you are this big. Okay, so if we say this is like our refinery room, We're gonna need, I usually have two of these, and then we're gonna need some other stuff that we could have across from it. We're also gonna need, we're gonna need some storage and stuff in here. So I'm thinking we're gonna put the elevator over here somewhere. Then we can put some storage around it or something, because we'll be bringing resources back down from this at some point. So yeah, I think right there would be a good spot. Yes, requires 50. So that's 50, 60, 70, well, they already used those, 80, and refinery floor takes 2 each, so that's like 88, but we still have over 50, over 60 left, so should be enough to get refinery going too, or refining. So here we can grow, we're gonna grow some potatoes, and I think we're gonna do a second set of potatoes. And then this one is gonna be hemp. There we go. I always forget to say plant. Oh, no, no, messed up. Clear. Potatoes. Plant. And potatoes and plant. Oh, there's fertilizer too. Oh boy, yes, there's so many things we have to get into. You can also manage who actually works at these places, but we don't have that many people right now. So Jim Scott is now a level 2 miner. Nice. Okay. So now someone should hopefully go and do something there. Did I get someone to do that? Yeah, William Adams should go and do some of that now. There we go, yes. And then let's see what's in this one. We have electronics, another colonist log, we got fasteners, clone chamber blueprint. Oh, that's awesome. We're gonna need this to get more people at some point. We can do some cloning. Storage expander, machine equipment. Ah, that's nice. Yep, okay. You are getting built, so I think the next thing we're gonna do is to get this so that we can generate more structure resin without having to get things. Oh, wrong way. There we go. You just press R to rotate. Yeah. I could do you. Let's see. Could also put you this way and have another one like this, then kind of do a little bit of a straight. I could do this differently than I usually do. Let's try and put it this way. Yeah, and then we can have like a doorway here, walls here, door here, get some storage in the middle, and then have some other crafting going on over here. I think that would be an idea. Okay, so now that we have that, what do you do? So connects the underground facilities to the surface. Power network info. Network power 0 volt, 0 volt. Network total power on. Network total stored on. Network total consumption 0. Okay, so electrical power is required by various machines. Machines can be connected to power by constructing power conduits that connect from under the machine to a power generator. Surface power. The primary facility on a surface map has a built-in solar panel. This power can be accessed by constructing an elevator. Power conduits placed under the elevator will allow you to access any power generated from a surface within the facility. Oh, cool. Then we have fuel power generators. The coal generator is a type of generator requiring fuel. You can see what fuel is required by clicking on the generator and viewing its information. Fuel is consumed at a constant rate while the generator is enabled. Fuel will be delivered by colonists with the hauler job role and is automatically prioritized over other hauling jobs. Oh, that's an important detail, this one actually. But yeah, usually you would start with one of these, but we don't anymore. Then there's geothermal. And then there's some power storage. Constructed batteries connected to a power network will store any excess power on a network. If you aren't generating enough power for your machines, then power will be taken from a battery if available. Oh, that is so cool. This is new as well. Okay, so this, of course, is gonna need power. So let's see. Power conduit. I think we are gonna... I'm gonna have a wall right here, so I think I kind of like the idea of that being brought up. I like putting the power under the walls, I don't know why, but I just do. I think we're gonna put it like this, and there we go. And then we can always bring it further up here to some other machines, and then we're gonna bring you, oops, over here underneath. And I think to make it easily accessible from all sides, we're just making a little circle here. Then we can always bring power out to other things. It's one thing to think about sometimes when you start putting walls in. Do keep that in mind if you wanted some power to some machines. They can access it when they're standing next to that. They can put power here if they're standing next to it. I put it underneath here though. But if you have a wall like here and you had some other stuff over here, then it can be hard to put power under something. So it's sometimes a good idea to get the power going before you put in walls and stuff, because suddenly you'll end up in a situation where you can't actually place any power conduits. So we are running out of stuff to mine. Let's just mine out some more stuff over here. Mine this. Oh, I'm paused. There we go. And we have some sand. Oh, there's more stuff here we can break down. And let's get this open up a little bit. Yeah, I think this is a good idea to use this as our water for a water supply that we're gonna need later. I don't think we're gonna need any more than that. So we're just gonna cover this up, and we can harvest these plants. I just wanna see how we're doing on food. Food, meal. We have 17 emergency rations. For raw food, we have the 6 arrowhead fungus, the ones we harvested. We haven't got potatoes yet, but they should be coming from here. So right now I don't wanna harvest these because I wanna see how long it's going to take for them to start spreading and how all of that works. Okay, so now they are fixing up the power conduits. Awesome. Which means we can start thinking about changing their job roles a little bit. This is the one we need. Oh, no. Oh, right. You have to change this. So this is for flooring if you want to deconstruct a floor, and this is for walls. And of course, if you have power underneath something, then you just click on that one, and the same for water conduits there. Aha, so that far, we got that far. Let's look into this. So you were a doctor, you're an engineer. I got someone assigned to be an engineer, so that's cool. And then you can do some extra mining if you don't have anything to construct. I think though that we're gonna change you to be a hauler. There we go. Because we're gonna start thinking about adding some storage. Dumping carried items on the floor. Uh-huh. Yeah, because we don't have any storage yet. And you can see, of course, what they're doing. Sleeping on the floor. We're gonna need beds and bedrooms and all kinds of stuff. Deconstructing wall. Let's see. You are doing that. And you are repairing things if needed. Then you're taking care of the plants, and then you do some extra mining if you don't have that to do for right now. You're probably going to change this to cooking once we get cooking going. You're also a doctor. Probably a good idea to always have two of them in case one of them is hurt or, you know, not able to do their job. And then you're going to be a scientist, which is kind of, you know, what you're going to be doing all the time. But if I forget to assign it or decide to take a break, I assign a new research project, and you can do some mining. Maybe I want you to do something else. Let's see. Mining is probably fine, but I think it might be good to have someone who can do a little bit of building. And of course you're doing these things, but you're gradually running out of power, so that's something to take into account. I need to get a chatting pad going for you, actually. This is done. Let's assign something. Of course we're gonna need structure resin, and I want to make sure you can choose just to craft a certain amount, but I want to make sure that we always have some. So craft if below X, and we always need a lot of this. So for now I think I want to make sure we always have 100. We can always change these numbers. So let's say apply. Now you're crafting that. What else can we craft in here? Bioplastic, that's what we need the hemp for. And I am thinking, let's just set you to maybe 50 or something. And then there's some cloth, which you're gonna need for beds. Also need the hemp for that. Craft was if below. Actually, I think I'm gonna set these a little lower. I think we need 10 or 20 or something for bets. It's not really my main priority right now, so I think we're just gonna put you to 20. Yeah. And you can pause these if you want to. Like if you click on this, then you can choose to pause it instead of removing it, or you can click on the X to remove it. Yeah, I think that's what we're gonna do right now. And then we are out of time, guys. So we are gonna continue with this next time. Oh, but this is so exciting. I love when there's new stuff. So we're gonna see if we can figure it all out and survive this. So thank you for watching, and as always, do take care and happy gaming.